This first story contains some information that we do not consider a spoiler, but we recognize some of you may, as it relates to a possible cameo in the film, so you may want to fast forward through this part. A copy of the official Guardians of the Galaxy end credits scroll has been released, and it contains some interesting information near the end. The first is the disclaimer that no raccoons or tree creatures were harmed during the making of the film. The second is the announcement that the Guardians of the Galaxy will return, and the third and possibly most interesting tidbit is the credit Howard the Duck created by Steve Gerber and Val Mayerick. John, what do you make of these three things?
Yeah, well, okay, first, the unimportant ones first. The whole no raccoons or trees were harmed during this, that's just funny. Mm-hmm. The Guardians will return confirms what we've all speculated and believed that, you know, we know they've got future plans for Guardians of the Galaxy. This was never going to be a one and done. So that's good to hear too. What has people really excited in certain circles right now is Howard the Duck is making a cameo appearance in the movie. I don't think that's the case. I don't think. Now, I'll be really.
Red herring?
I think I'll be really pleasantly surprised if that is the case, but I don't think it is. Considering it's kind of tacked on there right at the end of the credits, right, I have a feeling that we're going to see Peter Quill, Star-Lord, near the beginning when he's a kid still on Earth. I'm going to bet you he's like got a Howard the Duck comic book or something like that. We'll see a reference to it, but I don't think we're going to get. I hope I'm wrong. I think it'll be completely cool. When I go see Guardians of the Galaxy tonight, I think that would be really cool if he pops up, but the way this is structured, I don't think that's the way they're going for it. What do you think about it? You think he's going to be in there?
There'll be probably like a reference of sorts. I mean, think about it. Lucasfilm is now owned by Disney.
Yeah.
Has that entire library. So I could see a reference, a doll of some sort. Remember that Peter Quill, by what we know, is like a child of the 80s.
Yeah.
So it's perfectly within reason that
the timeline's right.
Yeah. He was abducted, and Howard the Duck was the hot movie back then.
I loved that movie when it came out. Everybody
knew
it.
Absolutely.
I really liked that movie when I was a kid.
So do you think he'll actually pop up there?
I would love it if he did, because it's one of those things that it was like this memory of my youth that nobody has touched since. So it would be kind of cool. I don't know.
What do you think, Christian?
I say yes. Yes, he will show up, and I'll tell you why, because it is no different than when Sonic the Hedgehog showed up in Wreck-It Ralph. It's just, if it is the perfect universe for this guy, for this duck to show up, it is in this movie. And it could be a passing by with a cigar. He gives a line, he takes off, he has a little back and forth with the raccoon, and people would go nuts. It doesn't have to be a huge part. It's a little thing, and I think it would be fun for people to recognize and go, hey, it's Howard the Duck. Awesome, because it fits in. It's not like putting him in like with Iron Man out of nowhere. Yeah. You're putting him in with Guardians of the Galaxy. Yeah, I think he'll show
up. You bring up the one really compelling argument about why you might want to think he'll be there, and that is, you're absolutely right. If you're going to put him in anywhere, this is the one you put him in. You don't put him in a Doctor Strange movie. You don't have Stephen Strange and Howard the Duck come walking. With Guardians of the Galaxy, if they did it, we wouldn't blink. We go, oh, it's Howard the Duck, but it wouldn't seem odd or unusual to us at all. So that's a really good argument.
Hey everyone, if you like this video, click that thumbs up button and make sure to subscribe to our AMC Movie News YouTube channel. It's free and helps you stay up to date with all the latest movie news, as well as our daily AMC Movie Talk show. Also, make sure that you follow us on Facebook and Twitter to stay up to date with all of our special promotions, contests, and prize giveaways.